بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته It's your brother Adil Malik here from Muslim Council of Hong Kong with yet another beautiful episode for Ramadan Reflections Alhamdulillah this is episode number 18 Alhamdulillah yesterday we had episode number 17 Alhamdulillah yesterday we talked about the topic of marriage and today I thought I'll pick the topic of family and just regarding with marriage again I like to again you know just to take a leaf out of the previous topic as well so with regards to marriage just remember brother and sisters right this is an encouraged act Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said those who do not marry they're not from me right basically we are encouraged to get married because this is one of the ways that of course our deen is protected within ourselves and it's one of the way where you know we can continue the Muslim progeny right so please if you're you know in this age of marriage get married soon now today the reason I picked this topic of family alhamdulillah in this month of Ramadan with reflections is because of this ayah which is in Surah Al-Furqan chapter number 25 and if you don't know this ayah and in this ayah is a beautiful dua alhamdulillah is one of my favorite duas and the dua goes like this rabbana hablana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata a'yunin waj'alna lil muttaqina imama I'm going to translate now Allah says and those who say this is the ayah now and then the dua Our Lord, grant us from among our wives and offspring, meaning children, comfort to our eyes and make us an example for the righteous. Now, Surah Al-Furqan basically means criterion. The criterion Allah explains in this surah, He's explaining those who are the wrongdoers and then He explains those who are the righteous. And in this dua, subhanAllah, Allah mentions that when we make this dua, we're asking for us to be from the righteous. We're asking for our spouses to be from the righteous. And we're asking for our offspring to be from the righteous. Now, isn't that what every single one of us wants, right? So, shouldn't be a case where we learn this dua, we reflect upon this dua, we recite this dua, and anytime, brothers and sisters, and this is the tested thing, I have tested this myself, anytime something doesn't work out between you and your spouse, between you and your children, recite this dua with yaqeen. Remember, I talked about this already. With yaqeen, with sincerity, that Allah will answer. Because look at the dua. Look what it's saying. Comfort to our eyes, right? So comfort to our eyes basically means it will bring us peace. This could go both ways. From the husband to the wife, to the wife to the husband, to the parents to the children, to the children to the parents. And remember, brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best of you are those who are best to the family. And then he said, the best of those are those who are best to their woman, meaning the wives. But again, the emphasis is so high with regards to family. And I'm going to make it quite general so that the parents can connect to the children can connect to the parents, and we can even open up our circle with regards to our brothers, sisters, and with regards to our uncle, aunties. Because again, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you want your provision, your rizq to be extended, one of the most beautiful ways to do that is to keep the ties of kinship. Keep your ties of family. Because when you do that, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there'll be barakah in your provision. And provision is so vast. It's not just talking about money. It's talking about knowledge. It could be talking about your family. And this is a topic in itself, inshallah. And again, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, spend on your family. Because when you spend on your family, it's an act of charity, right? So they're quite interrelated. Moreover, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that save yourself. This is actually from the ayah from the Quran. I say, save yourself and your family from the hellfire, because that is made of men and stones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is a long hadith. I'm just going to pick out the one that I want to do for the husband, for the parents, right? Which is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, every single one of you are a shepherd, and then he mentions many categories of a shepherd. One of the things he mentioned is a father is a shepherd, A mother is a shepherd to his or her flock. Meaning, we will be asked, we will be judged, we will be held accountable as parents, how we treated our flock, how we nurtured our flock, how we disciplined our flock, how we kept it connected to the deen of Allah regarding to our flock. And this is why the best investment that any parent can make is for them to connect their children to the deen of Allah. It's for them to connect them to the academic studies for fitness. And I mean, again, Islam is not just about, you know, the learning the Quran and the Hadith. Of course, that's really, really high, right? But even making them intellectually challenged in terms of the academics, giving them a high education, this is an act of worship from the parents if they really think about it. And the last thing I want to mention is a topic we've mentioned already two days ago, which is regards to dua. The dua of parents for their children and the dua for the children for the parents is so, so high, brothers and sisters, you cannot imagine. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the parents especially that one of the duas that Allah readily accepts is the dua of the father especially, and just the parents in general. But Allah even says, but if anybody does anything in anger, Allah says, I will not look into that. Subhanallah. You know, as parents, we might say something out of anger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people of patience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people so we can be a good role model for our children, inshallah, and make us a family in Jannah for those. Jazakallah khair for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.